Hello. We're gonna create, this is too loud. All right, so today's look is gonna be inspired by my painting and you're gonna see it at the end of this video. It's more of a galaxy inspired look. So let's get started with foundation. I'm starting only in the center of my face. How's everybody doing? Like, what is your new normal? Comment down below and share your experience. We're in this together. Look at this pimple. Ooh. Mountain on my cheek. Look at this. Makeup can only cover so much. But I'm playing reggae today because it's nice and relaxing. And I feel like we really need to choose our music wisely. Everything that we're listening to, you know? I've been wearing my hair natural. This is like third day hair. It gets just bigger and bigger and bigger as the days go. Like this video if you're a curly girl and you agree that your hair just continues to expand throughout the week. I love it though. The bigger hair, the better. I must ask you a question. A Cosmetics concealer. I'm just gonna dab it with that same brush, the Real Techniques brush. In this video, I'm gonna be talking about things that you can do while in quarantine. I painted. That's something that I love to do, is paint. And makeup and art is the same thing. Makeup artist. So I started as an artist first, and then I got into makeup. It just came natural to me, and I fell in love with how free I feel when I'm painting and how relaxing it is. I really, really love painting because it relaxes me. Any other artists out there that are watching, like this video and share your experience with art and how it makes you feel. I'm gonna be contouring just a little bit, not too much, because I wanna make sure that it's like lightweight and airy. I don't want too much shadow going on. So I'm just gonna place it. If you're not an artist and you're watching this, share your hobbies and what helps you get through this pandemic. It could be fitness, it could be writing. Let me know. Let me know what you do. I am curious. Another thing that you can do is if you've been wanting to remodel your room, remodel it. Change the color of the walls or just change around the placement of the furniture in your room. And if you are a subscriber to a magazine like Vogue, look through the Vogue magazines and see what inspires you. I always like to set the center of my face because I get greasy. So, going back to art, shading, highlighting, gradation of color, all of that sounds familiar, right? Well, the same techniques you use in makeup, you use in art when you're painting on a canvas. That means if you've already became an artist and you're already creating artwork on a canvas, makeup artistry will come natural to you because you're familiar with all the techniques. Especially color theory. Color theory is essential as a makeup artist. And artwork, when you're creating artwork on a canvas, you need to know your color theory to be able to mix different colors, to create a color story, to see which color stories create harmony together. So you want to make sure that you know your color theory. It's so important. that's just another familiar. It's another, sorry, I'm bilingual. Similar trait that art and makeup have in common. Also, the brushes that you use to apply your makeup, we're using a brush that's smaller. It's for more of detail work. Same thing applies to when you're painting on a canvas. You use a small brush for detail work and a larger brush for a larger surface of coverage. And that's why when you're applying your foundation as a makeup artist or as a person who wears makeup, you use a foundation brush. It's usually flat to create more opaque coverage, or it's dense. This one I just used on my face. That's why it's dirty, because I literally just used it. But you can see that it's very dense and it's meant to apply on a large surface area. So a color that's opaque and full coverage. Same thing with a canvas. The larger the brush, the less detail work, the more diffused, and the smaller the brush, the more opaque and defined the finish will be. Also, you know how we apply texture in our makeup look, like glitter or metallic finish or satin or matte? Same thing applies to a canvas. When you're painting on a canvas as an artist, you play with textures, you play with glitter, you play with different types of finishes on your canvas. That's the art and the beauty of it. It's so amazing. When I'm painting, I usually just go with what I'm creating. It's usually not planned, it just becomes. And don't you feel the same way when you're applying makeup? That it just becomes something? Usually with makeup you plan it, but then you create your own finish. It could be a reference picture that you're using. The finish that you create is your own though. That's why it's called an inspiration. Because you end up putting your own type of twist to the design, which is gorgeous. For when I used to teach makeup classes, I would give a picture to my students and they would have to recreate it as an inspiration, right? And there were a few students who had the same picture to recreate. They had a similar color story, but the techniques and the finish was a little different because it had their own distinct style. The same thing happens with artwork. And I think that's so beautiful. And that's something that I would always embrace with my students. If you're watching, you guys, you know that's what's up. I really did embrace your unique talent and your unique finish and techniques. And I'm proud of you. I could teach you how to apply makeup. You take your own technique and your own twist to it and make it yours. And that's the beauty of art. I've been using a lot of natural colors lately in my makeup looks. I wanted to change it up. Why not? We can definitely take this time that we have and connect with one another here on social media. It's so much fun. Another thing that you can do at home to become creative is just cook and bake cakes or cake pops, watch your favorite movie, communicate with family members that you haven't spoken to in a while, and just relax, meditate, dance, have fun. There's a app called TikTok that it's a dancing app. So if you like to dance and you like to share all that flavor and that salsa or whatever it is that you like, rap, hip hop, whatever it is, you can share your passion on there with other people from around the world, which is really neat because you're connecting with people even though you're not going out. You're in your house, safe and sound, and you're connecting with people. And if you have a pet, you can train them to do something else. A trick. Start to look through the clothes that you have that don't fit you or you haven't worn. They say that if you haven't worn something in 4 years, that you should give it away. You can definitely start doing that. Organize your room. Read a book. Try different styles with your hair. I have tutorials on my Instagram TV, on my Facebook, and on my YouTube. Tutorials for how to style your hair, how to color your own hair, all of that. Check them out after you finish watching this video. That's something you can do. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Go through my page, like my post, share them. You never know who you're inspiring on your own page to create as well. That's why I create all this content, because I want to make sure that I inspire people to think outside the box, you know? It's so important to feed into your creative energy and just experiment. Why not, right? Another thing you can do, watch live concerts of your favorite bands or your favorite musicians and jam out. Have your own little party, you guys. Just have fun and have good vibes. If you're into cars, start tuning the car, changing the oil, waxing the car. Catch up on that. Take advantage of this time. If you're subscribed to Apple Music, or you have Spotify, Pandora, whatever it is you may have, create a new playlist for every type of mood, you know? My message to you, don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing's gonna be alright. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing's gonna be alright. Ooh, I feel like Ursula right now. If you're a musician and you like to write music, whether it be song lyrics or actual music, like music notes, start to create your music and share it with the world. Connect with other musicians, and you never know where that can take you. And for people who are watching that are into fitness, you can still work out at your house. And if you're gonna go out in your neighborhood and take a walk or a run or a bike, make sure you take hand sanitizer, water, your phone. Make sure you stay 6 feet away from people, because not everybody's as careful as you. Let's cut this brief. So I did this all off camera because I forgot to press record after I cut up the crease. Sorry. I had to go get a snack. It's time for my eyeliner. This is the magnetic liner. Are we gonna wing this out? No. This is magnet eyeliner that I'm applying. And I have to let this dry so that I can put on magnetic lashes. So the lashes have magnets on them and they connect with this liner, which is awesome. While that's drying, the finer the brush, the more detailed work you're gonna create. I'm just putting my luminizer using Morphe. Look at that, baby. Glitter, baby. Glitter, baby. This is a very Instagram kind of makeup look. Ooh. Where I look like a glazed donut. I mean, why not, you know? Let's put on our lashes. There you go. How about that? I sell these magnetic lashes. The link is on KianaGosta.com. And I have a video tutorial on how to use them. And my affiliate link is included. These are Tori Bell magnetic lashes, and I sell them. I'm an affiliate with them. So, you guys, look at the difference it made. Get them. They're gonna change your makeup game for sure. You see how easy it was to place them? And I'm done with my eyes. Now I'm gonna be going into my lips with a lip pencil. There.